Hi guys, today we have a video about man's resistance Gelandewagen with 650 HP. In the previous episode you might remember that we took him to a very expensive landing spent in Kyiv. Before painting we had removed the axles from it, they're in the box right now. Also we had brought it to our base and scaled all the fasteners. After that we gave it to some blast and powder painting. I think you want to ask about accessory worth of painting. To reply you, I invite the specialist who will tell you about this later. So guys, we took our axles after some glass and powder painting. We are often asked about the use of powder painting by you. Firstly, it's the lack of acrylic primers and paints the same durability properties as powder, because after some glass you apply a special primer, whose name I don't remember due to my guys do it, and powder paint on the ideal surface. After it, it is baked at 200 degrees and of course it holds up very well after that. So, we simply assemble the side gearboxes and central gearboxes and prime them with epoxy primer and black poured sand paint in our box. Why don't we paint it all with powder? We don't want to warm up, because the bearings which would be weaked as a result of high temperature. I don't want to tempt fate. In general, it holds perfectly, after all on perfectly flat surface, which was made by sandblasting. Epoxy soils perfectly and it is very strong. So, guys, there are our levers. Pen hard rods, they are sandblasted and painted, so we are starting to replace the silent blocks. We have already bought the original ones. See that a whole bunch of them. It's enough for two cars here. We're going to replace good silent blocks and replace them with the new ones, due to client's wish. Despite the fact that these ones are really good, but we will replace them. Let's see what we have here. There are 12 silent blocks, with big metallic loop here. Also we have 12 bushing here. We also painted and sandblasted washer. All is fine. I mean, we will replace nuts after a while by new galvanized ones due to rust. And it's not cool, guys. Pan-hut rods, as you can see, are welded, but we made them as convenient for us as possible. So it's around the cadre, around the gearbox. All it's fine. Also this transit, it's for sure. They are not just solid, but they are cast. I mean, there isn't any void in the pipe, and we strange it with the metal, in the places where welding was. You can see we took probably 10 silent blocks, because original ones are unavailable, or it's need of 2 weeks of delivery. And this is too long, so we need to probably 10. Moreover, they were walled longer than original ones. Well, guys received the call about the end of painting of the car. The price which is $5,500. It's expensive, isn't it? We load the car with axles, drum carts, a wrench and go to get the gun. Well guys, it's the most interesting part of the video. What is Linux? Why it's so expensive? What is good for? Let's ask a specialist. Hello everyone, my name is Sergey. Our company Armline is the official representative of Linux in Ukraine. We have been doing it for 5 years, since 2013. By the way, this car is painted 5 years ago. You can see what it looks like, because I am often asked about problems which can happen after a while. Let's go inside, I will show a car which have just finished. You can see this car. The car was completely dismantled. Even the elements that were not visible were painted. This inner part of the bumpers, the part under the windshield where corrosion most often begins. I mean that the material, in addition to the direct proposed protection against stick fragments, is good as anti-corrosion agent for the car body. It also presents itself as excellent anti-theft tool, because such cars are not attractive to hijackers, due to the difficulty of removing it compared to the BMW brand. Another common question is about colors. It can be whatever you want. Moreover, it can be a combination of few colors, patterns or drawings, any desire for your money. Well, and the most interesting aspect is about the resistance of the material to physical stress. We won't show it by the client's car, but we can demonstrate it on the metal plate which is covered by Linux, and about the same thickness. So we can see hits and scratches. First sharp, then blunt. Well, you can probably see that it can resist to any physical impact. So it can be unscathed by branches. So, guys, we took our 6x6 Gelandewagen, which is painted by Linux. This is very beautiful, I'm honestly impressed. You can see it under the sun, it's beautiful, it's shining so cool. The sky is on fire, isn't it? Black checkmate. Our 6x6 Gelandewagen is of course shiny and glamorous. This car is for driving around the city and hook up girls. It's really an aggressor. You can drive directly in the forest without fear of scratches. Have you seen the test? Hit it with a screwdriver or hit it with a hammer? Nothing, it's really not a problem. I had a look and I was shocked. How does it resist all this? I think that is like a molten plastic, like a whole car is laminated. This layer is 3 mm thick. This is very serious. I tried to tear a piece of Linux and I wasn't successful. This is very strong and reliable thick. As for the quality of painting, I really like it, it's very beautiful. We're connecting the string rods now, half we have from a plunder, half from Gelandewagen. This is very unpleasant aspect for me. If you remember our video about 4x4 Gelandewagen, after a tough test, the string rod broke there. I was shocked. At this time we are going to strengthen this as much as possible. I will tell you and I will show you it. We took the bushing and stuck into two pipes. Then we welded all through the hole. We have moved the metal a little, you understand, we don't think about the beauty. We checked from start to finish, it's normal starting corner. After we welded the string rod and lower rod, we disassembled it and moved it to sandblast and powder paint. And the tips were painted by epoxy primer and polyurethane paint. For painting, we did not have time to make a back arch, and now, upon arrival, we took a thick-walled stainless steel pipe and are starting to make the rear arch. There is, guys, some windows. They are already made glasses for CV6 G-Wagons. First, we made the template out of plywood, sent it to the factory, and according to the template, we made template glass with a thickness of 4 mm. Here we have already toned some glasses. We selected their membrane so that it will be the same in tonality as the factory one. So today or tomorrow we will install it all. On this, guys, I'm ending the video. Support the video with like and goodbye. We have a lot of work.